Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. So as you can see, I have nothing on my lips, which means I will be doing a review on some lipsticks. And today's lipsticks are going to be the new Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics lipstick. Now I'll be swatching them. I will be giving you my first impressions, my overall opinion. I'm going to be giving you details on my shipping, and I will kind of touch up on the conspiracies and theories and the tea and all that jazz. So if you would like to hear my opinions and see what I think of the three colors that I have, which are Perfectionist, Sophia, and That Girl, then go ahead and keep on watching. All right, so the first thing I want to kind of open these babies up and then go from there because I want to put some lipstick on. This is what the package came in. It's just a little bubble wrap type of bag. It has J all over for Jaclyn Hill. And there's a little plastic wrap that this came in. Pretty secure way to ship a product, especially a lipstick. So I did buy the Nude Moment Lipstick Trio. All these three did come in this little package right here, which is kind of like a textured little white box with Jaclyn here. So that's interesting because she did rename it Jaclyn Cosmetics. It's not Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics. Interesting. I guess she's really not trying to pay out any money to John, huh? So the trio did retail for $49. Each lipstick was $18. So by buying the bundle, you are saving a little bit of money. My shipping was free and my Florida state tax was $2.94. And the Lee County tax was 25 cents. So my total came to $52.19. I did not buy any kind of expedited shipping. I was like, I'm not spending extra money on this. Not worth it because the lipsticks are expensive to begin with. Outside packaging is fine. I'm not like, oh my God, this is the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. It's very Jaclyn. I wasn't expecting anything less than that. I think she could have went with maybe not texture packaging and made it cheaper for us. I don't know. That's just my opinion because this is something that gets tossed away, but this is also something that we're in essentially paying for. The actual lipstick wise, I think they're pretty cute. You know, they're little thick bullets. I'm just gonna grab one and kind of talk about it. She made a huge deal saying that, oh, I worked so hard to make sure that the diamond actually looks like a diamond inside, which is fine, but I feel like if it was just a diamond slapped on top, I would not be able to tell the difference. The bullet itself is nice and glittery, but it's not harsh. Like, it's laminated on top, so there's not gonna be any glitter fallout or anything. It just looks nice. And then there's a JH, which that is honestly like some kind of inconsistency because the company, it's called Jaclyn Cosmetics, and JH is all over them, as in Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics, which is weird to me. So I feel like these were definitely produced at like very different time frames, and then they didn't want to produce the tubes again, so they just changed the name of the company but still kept the JH. That is my opinion. This kind of pops off, but it has little bubbles so that the lipstick securely kind of snaps into place, which is great. Just any kind of normal bullet kind of lipstick, it just rolls out. I am interested in see on how these are going to apply because I am seeing little black dots in this lipstick. It's funny because if it was something that was not discussed in videos and if I had not watched any of the drama videos, I would not have even like known to look for something like that. But looking up close to this lipstick, there are black dots. Now, I'm not sure if those are little air pockets or if they are black dots. Color is That Girl, which I feel like this one's actually the one that a lot of people have been bringing up that has some issues. So a lot of the like chemists that are making videos about this are kind of saying that if the certain ingredients in here got too hot too fast and melted and didn't refreeze fast enough, then these pockets could have created themselves or bubbled up and things like that. But the fact is, these lipsticks stayed in the same shape. Like, if this has all molten down and then there were random holes inside, that would make sense. But I don't think this lipstick actually got high enough where that chemical reaction would have even happened, because I assume that it would have to have been very high heats. And honestly, the matter of fact is, Jaclyn lives in Florida, which is where I live. If she was using these lipsticks, you know, she would have them in her purse, which you would be taking to your hot ass car that's not immediately cold when you get inside. So this lipstick would have been exposed to that high heat. I think that maybe she did see these things and just assume that no one would like notice it, but it's pretty noticeable. And I feel like with her company, people are just literally looking for little things to like talk about, so people are definitely like putting this under a microscope way more than any other lipstick company. But I've never gotten a lipstick before where I saw anything like this on them, you know what I mean? And then this is Sophia, and Sophia honestly looks perfect. Okay, Sophia looks perfect besides the fact that at the bottom, it looks like it was cut and like smushed into something else. Okay, so let me just grab some lipsticks. What I haven't really seen anyone do is grab a whole bunch of other kind of lipsticks and inspect them in that kind of way. So I have a MAC lipstick, I have a ColourPop, I have an Anastasia, I have a Maybelline, and a Bite Beauty. Okay, so MAC is going to be kind of the closest option. There's a little bit of texture that comes off from the skin to the lipstick, that's really fine, but I'm not seeing any bubbles, I'm not seeing any beads, I'm not seeing any air pockets, and I'm definitely not seeing any kind of any lines right at the rim here. Like, it looks like this lipstick was boop, melted right into here and shaped. So not seeing any of that. Let's look at ColourPop. Definitely not seeing any lines. Now, this is also a clear tube up here, so if there were any lines, you'd be able to see it because this is see-through. No bubbles, lip texture on here, which is normal. Like, your lips have a texture. They might not be crusty, but they still have a texture that's going to come off on the lipstick as the lipstick glides on. This is an Anastasia lipstick, my favorite one. Once again, texture, a little bit of balling up, but that is just because I use this over different products. Once again, no sign of lines at the rim here. This one has a good amount of texture. This one was melted. But even so, if this was melted, I'm not seeing any actual bubbles. It's just texture from me using it. But it's like melted, like you can see that it's melted all over the place. And then there's a Bite Beauty one, which I don't know what happened to this one. I think the way that this melted kind of created texture around the rim. But there are no holes, no bumps, besides the texture that would come from the lips. So without further ado, I'm just going to, I guess, put these on my lips. So the one that kind of looks the best is going to be, it was not Perfectionist, it was Sophia. But Sophia is the one that looks like it has been cut. But this is what Sophia looks like, and let's swatch a little bit of this. This is what Sophia looks like. These are very, very buttery, not matte at all. Just feel very, very hydrating. Also, smell-wise, honestly, it's funny because that girl Shay said it smelled like Play-Doh, and I'm smelling Play-Doh. Like, Play-Doh has that plasticky smell, but it also has kind of like a sweet scent to it. Smells Play-Doh-y. Slightly vanilla-y. It's funny, she made like this big deal about how it smells so amazing and how she worked so hard on that, so I don't know about that. Like, I think that's one of those things that no one would have even like talked about, but she made such a big deal saying like, oh my god, I worked so hard on the smell. Okay, I'm gonna need a little bit of some kind of lip liners. I'm gonna go in with a little bit of Strip Down by MAC and like even this out. Okay, this is about as good as this shit's gonna get. So I'm gonna swatch the other ones on my hand. Then I have Perfectionist, which this is the one that has very, very visible air pockets at the top. This middle shade is going to be Perfectionist. It's super pinky. And then the last one I have is That Girl, which this one is kind of dinged at the top here. And has little black dots, which I can't tell if they're beads or if they are something else. This is going to be That Girl. That one I feel like is the most creamy. It just like really got smushed when I was putting it on, and I'm really not doing a lot of pressure. So I'm just gonna... dab this on top. Okay, so two little chunks came out, so I'm not quite sure if it's like little beads. I'm gonna try. Okay, they're big beads. Oh my god. Okay, so that is a bead. It's a bright pink bead. I'm gonna see if I can take a picture of this because this will absolutely not show up on camera. So That Girl is the one that I said that had like bead looking like things inside, and I wasn't sure what they were. I'm gonna insert the picture of what the texture of the lipstick looks like after I dabbed it on my lips and did like a swatch, and also the pink bead. And the pink bead wasn't something like a balled up lipstick. Like, I kept doing this with it in my hand and it kept staying a bead. Like, if it was a piece of lipstick that had melted together or something might have happened, it wouldn't have turned into a bead. Like, what the fuck is this bead? I do think that they're very nice and creamy. They're very hydrating. This is not going to be long lasting at all by any means. These are definitely going to kind of smush around, and without a lip liner, I feel like they might be hard to apply because they kind of just go everywhere. Those are the three shades that I have. These are way all too pinky for me. This is where I'm gonna leave the little like swatches and review part of that, and I want to kind of jump into the shipping stuff that happened. So the order was put in at 2:48 p.m. so her launch was at 9 Pacific time, which would have been noon at my time. So 2 hours and 48 minutes after her launch, there was still a whole bunch of stuff left on the site, so it didn't sell out immediately. And I ordered the bundle because I felt like that's going to be a good price point. So I'm not paying exactly $18 per lipstick. So I was like, cool, sweet, let me get the bundle. So I ordered it on May 30th. 2 hours and 48 minutes after the launch. Okay, cool, got a confirmation that these are my goods. Great, nude stick moment, paid $49 with all the taxes, was $52.19, great. So this was 3 days after the launch. I then just got a shipment confirmation, which is kind of insane because at this point on June 2nd, people literally had their lipsticks. And then just yesterday on June 7th, they were delivered. So 5 days for shipping, 3 days for processing, which is kind of insane considering that I ordered it on launch day. Oh, shipping sucked. I know that a lot of people got their money refunded because they weren't really expedited fast enough, so they refunded people, which is kind of nice instead of keeping the money. So that's that. Conspiracy theory wise, there's a ton. I have a couple of theories on what this could be, all relating to Morphe. They're Morphe lipsticks just put into Jaclyn Hill packaging, or Morphe produced her lipsticks for her. Yeah, so I feel like Morphe's definitely involved in some kind of way within this launch. And of course she's not gonna say so because people are sick and tired of her and Morphe. There's a lot of drama with like batch codes now and trying to figure out when these were actually made. Other theories are the fact that these are like 2 years old. They're just repackaged. And also obviously the drama with the whole bubbles and the beads and looking like these lipsticks were literally chopped and repackaged into this packaging. I really was hoping that I was not one of the people that was going to get these kind of shitty lipsticks because I paid $52 for this. So I was hoping that mine are gonna come good. Also just the worry of if these are old, I don't want to be putting them on my lips. Honestly, I started watching Jaclyn years and years and years ago, pre-lip injections. Pre-divorce, she was like the first makeup YouTuber that I watched, and I loved her and John. I truly honestly related to her because at that point I was dating a musician, and there were a lot of things that I felt like she probably was going through because not musicians are the same. It's just someone who I related to. She was funny to watch. She was very laid back. You could tell that she was, you know, really into makeup, and she was just likable. And then the bigger that she got, the more changes I saw, and then the more I kept stepping away. I feel like once she really started pushing Morphe, I was like, I'm out. And that's kind of when I saw her in the true light of just like cranking products out to make more money. And it's like, yeah, like your millions of dollars is not really enough in your bank account. You have to completely screw people over and just not be honest about what is really happening. I just don't like people who are out there to make a dollar off of someone else. And I know how hard it is to earn your money, and it's like spending your hard-earned dollars on something that's so shitty is just so disheartening to me. So I don't like these lipsticks. I don't want them. Will I still buy Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics if she comes out with something new? Yeah, but for review purposes, not because I think the products are going to be great. Like, I don't trust her at all on this. And I saw her, like, clap back at people on Twitter. And funny enough, people are pulling up Twitter posts from, like, 2 years ago of lipsticks that had air bubbles in them. And she's like, bad batch. It's like, okay, clearly you didn't test these enough or whatever. Like, fire your chemist, if anything. But I feel like if you truly worked on this for so long, and you truly wanted to put your heart and soul, and you're very OCD about making sure everything's perfect, well, the smell is average. The packaging is cute, yeah, but it also looks like your product sucks shit. So, like, I would rather have a very basic packaging and make this cheaper, but make it a bomb product. I don't know. That's just my opinion. Don't like these lipsticks. This is where I'm going to leave this out at. I probably will get backlash for this because people are so obsessed with Jaclyn and they're just going to be like, you're dumb, blah, blah, blah. But whatever. More of you people are going to come at me. But, you know, it is what it is. This is an honest channel. I'm going to tell you exactly how I feel. I don't care to be on people's PRs list. And I'm not gonna kiss ass just to be huge on YouTube. Like, that's just not where I'm at. I want to do an honest review on everything that I get either sent to me or that I buy. And I spent my hard-earned money on this and it's a bust and I will never like reach for these. And they're not my aesthetic, so it's not like I can be like, oh, well, look at the packaging's cute. Like, I'll set it out. Like, no, that's just not the case. Let me know how you feel down in the comments. If you order these, let me know what you think. If you've had a successful purchase from this, also let me know down below. Let's have a courteous and kind discussion in the comments below. And yeah, so I'm checking out here. Thank you so much for watching me rant. I needed to get some things off my chest because I'm bothered. Hopefully I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Yeah, transfers. It transfers.